Hello everyone. In the previous tutorial, we discussed the essential points in solving differential equations in MATLAB. Now it is time to get to know some advanced stuff. I'm going to talk about changing the precision of our solutions, MATLAB solvers other than ODE45, and some other materials. So watch this tutorial until the end. I start by a simple example so that you remember the previous lesson. Solve this differential equation in the given interval and initial condition. And this is the exact solution of the ODE. We will use it to check our results. The ODE is already in the standard form, so I just need to define this function. I can define it as an anonymous function or as a separate function. Now I write the ode45 command. If I use my anonymous function handle, I do not need the at sign, since it is already written here. But if I use the function f2, I must add an at sign to use it as a function handle. Then I add the integration interval and initial condition. I also plot the result. Now suppose you want to find out the effect of initial conditions on the results, or you want to solve it with multiple initial conditions. Fortunately, you can run ODE45 with multiple initial conditions. You just need to put a vector as your initial condition. So I type 1:5:3. It goes from 1 to 3 with a step size of 0.5. You see MATLAB solve the ODE for 5 different initial values, and the answer to all of them are stored inside Y. Now let's take a look at T. It goes from 0 to 2 as expected, and it has discretized the interval into 41 points. MATLAB has decided that 41 points is accurate enough for our problem. But what if I wanted to know the result in more number of points or less number of points? Again, we can have control over the middle points. This time, instead of specifying the start and final points of the interval, I select the middle points too. For example, I want to discretize the interval into 81 points. You can see that the number of middle points have increased. Or I can have the answer for only 11 points. Do not get confused. Changing the number of middle points does not affect the precision of your results. Even if I ask for only 3 points, MATLAB solves the ODE with its preferred middle points. Then it interpolates the answer to give my desired results. So I repeat myself again. Changing the number of middle points does not affect how MATLAB solves the ODE. It has no effect on the precision of our result. I changed the time span back to 0 and 2. If you want the result in some other points, there is another method. You can create a function for the solution of your ODE. To do that, just run ODE45 with a single output argument, which I name sol here. I run the code to see what this new variable is. It is a structure, and its fields contain the solution of our ODE. Now you must use this function, deval, and its first argument will be sol. Now I can type any number between 0 and 2, and it will return the solution of my ODE, which is stored here. For example, I can find the values of my solution in 81 points like this. You may also want to create a function out of this solution. I name it yfunc. Now I can use this function easily. Also use it to plot the result. But keep in mind that this function is defined only in this domain, 0 to 2. Now suppose you want to solve the same equation in this interval with this initial condition. Here our initial condition is not in the beginning of our time span. What should we do? If I simply change the time span, the initial condition will be associated with minus 1, not 0. The solution is to solve the ODE in two steps. First, I solve it for 0 until minus 1, then I solve it for 0 until 2. This way, in both command lines, the initial condition is implemented correctly. I name one pair of the solutions t back and y back, and the second pair t forward and y forward. Now I merge the answers to get t and y on the complete interval. The only problem is that for the back part, t goes in the negative direction. So it must be reversed. I accomplish it by using flip command. It reverses this vector. Now I want to increase the accuracy of my solution. In this case, I know the exact solution, so I can compare my answer to sqrt of t squared plus 1. Comparing these numbers will show that the accuracy of my numerical result is of order 6. This is the default error used by ODE45. To change the default setting, use this function, ODESet. The most common way of using this function is setting the absolute error tolerance and relative error tolerance to desired precision. You can see their default values. So basically, when you're solving for y, MATLAB iterates the solution until the error becomes either smaller than the absolute error or smaller than y times relative error. So if you want a solution with a precision of order minus 10, you can set both the relative and absolute tolerance to 1 e minus 10. The output of ODE set is stored in a variable, which is usually named options. And I add it to my ode45 command. You can check that the result is much more precise now. Besides ode45, MATLAB has other solvers too. Here is a list of differential equation solvers in MATLAB. I will talk about stiff ODEs later, but for now you can see that ode45 is the preferred solver. Let's solve the same equation with ODE23. As you can see in this case, the error is much higher than solving with ODE45. Now if I increase the error tolerance using ODE set to say for example 1 in minus 10, we can see that the number of points has increased dramatically. It means that for this solver, providing this accuracy has been very tough and inefficient. If you are interested in finding out more about these solvers, in the help bar type ODE. Then select choose an ODE solver. It can be helpful. Thank you for watching. In my next tutorial, I'm going to talk about solving ODEs with Symbolic toolbox. Please subscribe to my channel so you won't miss other tutorials. Bye bye.